Good evening, this is Ganzonomy. Today we have in front of you the Kodak Brownie Reflex Synchro model, a 1940s pseudo TLR by Kodak that was designed to give the semblance of an actual TLR without the cost. This camera retailed for about $6 back in 1941, and in 1950 retailed for about $11. Probably somewhere, I would say, in the $80 to $100 range in 2021 money. Looking at the front, we see a very large viewing glass, and at the bottom, we see a meniscus lens. We also see the shutter release. It does not have double exposure protection. So had I film in there, that would have been 6 exposures on the same piece of film. It has flash connectors and a bulb instant switch. Right now it's an instant. With some effort, can be set to B for bulb. And then you can hold open the lens as long as possible. If you look closely, you can see the shutter moving. Each time I hit B for bulb with the shutter button released. Up here we have the viewfinder, which pops open and reveals a very large viewing glass into a reflex mirror to the front lens. What is nice is it's very clear and easy to use. I had to use some acetone to clean the lens, but nevertheless, it came out nicer than expected. Back here we have the film counter, red window, and the open and close switch, switching this to open. You can lift off the body and reveal the film chamber. It takes 1 5/8 by 1 5/8 inch negatives, and the 127 is a roll format. Think of it kind of like a baby 620 spool, if you will. Your photos are square, and you get 12 per roll. Putting the camera back together involves simply putting everything back in place as it was, and turning the lever back to locked. So it's really not a particularly complicated camera. It has flash sync. It has bulb and instant. It does not have anything resembling double exposure protection. It does look like a pseudo TLR, because it is, when you lift up the viewfinder hood. I got this for $3 at an antique store, and it smelled. It was brown and covered in Lord knows what, but some lens cleaner, some acetone, and about an hour and a half and many Q-tips later, you see the result in front of you. I do not know if this will ever be a shooting camera. I did forget to mention the wind mechanism is down here to wind your film. But as a display piece, I like it. And it is actually the first camera that I've successfully repaired. If you like this video, please subscribe. Thank you. I do appreciate subscribers. I do respond to comments. Also hit the like button. This is Ganzonomy signing out. Have a good evening and stay safe.